Welcome back, friends. Welcome to another video from Shomu's Biology. And in this video, we are going to talk about the difference between transformation and transfection. I heard this question a long time ago, that what is the major difference between transformation and transfection? And people are wondering about the stuff that both of them deliver the same kind of situations, same kind of techniques. So why we call them in a different way? Now, the easy way someone can tell you that transformation is a process of delivering a genetic element inside a bacterial cell, while a transfection is the delivery of a genetic element inside a eukaryotic cell. Now, the thing is, if the things are the same, that is the idea that we have a cell and we need to deliver something from outside, some genetic material from outside, that could be DNA or that could be RNA. We need to deliver it inside that cell. And we can use either of the process, transformation or transfection. So why we give two different names? Now, transformation, as I told you, transformation, this term is generally applied for bacteria or prokaryotes, right? And you know the process of transformation. While there is a bacterial cell placed there, and obviously there is a genetic element, say the DNA, the fragments of the DNA. Now that DNA will bind to a specific receptor that is present in the surface of the bacterial cell, and then the DNA will be single-stranded. One strand will be degraded, so it will be single-stranded. It will be made single-stranded. Then it is uptaken inside the bacterial cell. So this is the idea of transformation. Now if you look at the transfection on the other hand, the idea almost kind of the same. That is, this is the eukaryotic cell, let's say this is the eukaryotic cell, okay, and there is a fragment of DNA that is present outside. Let's see this. Now the delivery of this fragment DNA inside the eukaryotic cell requires something more complex, right? Not that easy like it is been done in case of bacteria or prokaryotes, because eukaryotes are much more complex system to deal with. So what we need to do, there is no direct process. Eukaryotes or eukaryotic cell not generally uptake DNA or genetic segment inside the DNA, not naturally. So if we need to insert a DNA segment inside the eukaryotic cell, we need to do it outside. We need to do it with another extra technique, not naturally, okay? So in that case, we'll develop a technique. We need to put this DNA fragments inside a vehicle. Any sort of vehicle, that could be a virus, we can insert them inside a virus, okay, or it could be any kind of, we can insert it in any kind of vector like plasmid, for example. So by either way, inside a plasmid or a virus, then we take that and infect. If it's a virus, we infect the eukaryotic cell. By that way, that fragment will be internalized. Or if it's a vector, then we'll deliver that vector using, there are different techniques are out there, like microinjection could be done, where we can directly insert the DNA inside the nucleus of the eukaryotic cell. Because you know, the difference is the process, it's the idea is the same, but the difference in their process. As you know, in bacteria, transformation kind of a natural thing, because bacteria tends to develop certain antibiotic resistance things. So for that reason, this transformation is a one type of reproductive strategies that they have, one type of strategy to share their genetic material with the fellow. That is one thing. But in eukaryotes, that's not the truth. Eukaryotes, it's completely unnatural. We are doing this from outside. So that is one thing. Another thing, as bacterial cell or prokaryotic cell does not contain any sort of nucleus or system. Everything is floating in the cytosol. So it's very easy to insert something inside the bacterial cell. But in eukaryotes, everything is packed in the nucleus, right? So the genetic material we want to deliver, we need to insert it into the nucleus of the eukaryotic cell. And the nucleus is completely separate. So we need to do a lot of hard things, because first the cell membrane has a barrier, then the nuclear envelope has a barrier, then it will be inside the nucleus. So these are the fundamental difference between the two. Another difference is the transformation. This DNA fragment which is taken inside. Now, after the uptake of the DNA fragment, the fate of the DNA fragment definitely should be integrated with the host genome. Because if the fragment is placed surrounding the genome or is just scattered, it will be degraded. It will not produce any sort of proteins or stuff. So it should be integrated with the host genome, which is also easy for bacteria. Just integration using homologous recombination. But in case of eukaryotes, we need to make sure that we deliver it exactly inside the nucleus so that it can be integrated. See, in most of the cases of the transfection process, that is the delivery of gene in eukaryotes, we can say, we rely on using viruses because retroviruses have the strategy or tendency to integrate their genome with the host genome. Okay, so that's why you use retroviruses to insert the genome directly. So this is the fundamental difference. So as you know, the process is different, but the idea is the same. So why giving two separate names? We can give it like transformation of prokaryotes, transformation of eukaryotes. But why we give transfection? Now, one probable reason for that, I think, is that transformation, this term for eukaryotic cell, refers as the transformation of cell into cancerous cell. So when a normal cell becomes cancerous, that phenomena is known as transformation in eukaryotes. That is why if we keep the same name for eukaryotes, for transformation, that means a change of genetic element, it would create confusion. So to delete that confusion, to erase that confusion, we give a separate name, that is transfection, okay, which will not tally with any other processes. You know, whenever you are giving or naming something, a process, you should make sure that that name is unique. It's not copied or it's not duplicated from some. Because if it's duplicated, referring to that name will give so many options. It is confusing, right? So deal with that. I think you give transfection. In case of bacteria, it's transformation. But either way, this is the idea of transfection or transformation. Now, another thing I can tell you, in case of transformation, the element that we provide all the time, in fact, most of the time, is the DNA as a genetic element. But in case of transfection, we can do with DNA or RNA. We can use both of them, DNA or RNA, as this agent, using miRNA, siRNA. Those are the things that we nowadays do for the gene silencing studies and the other studies, like prolonged effect, to see the prolonged effect, any gain of function mutation or loss of function mutation studies in eukaryotes. Okay, so this, in a sense, is the difference between the transformation and transfection. I hope now you understand this concept. So thank you for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel to get more videos like that. Thank you.